Maybe not all of it. That has been preached before. Again, if you're taking notes or anything, I've titled this The Potter's Wheel, The Do-Over. I mean, you know, sometimes, you know, we need a do-over. You know? We need another chance. We need another opportunity. You know, sometimes we make messes and you know, we lean on our own understanding and, you know, I'm going to tell you God's grace and mercy. You know, he gives us a do-over. He wants to reestablish us. He wants us to be rekindled and restructured, if you will, unto his marvelous light and to his glory. Heavenly Father, Lord, we just thank you for your mercy and grace, Father God. Father God, I pray, Father God, that you remove me to the side, Father God, use me as your vessel. Father God, let every word that proceeds out of my mouth, Father God, let it be by your glory and by your truth, Father God. That you, Father God, would lead me, Father God, lead by direction. Father God, that every heart and mind would be open, Father God, to receive your glory. In Jesus' precious name, we give it all to you. And everyone says,
Amen.
So again, we're coming out of the book of Jeremiah, chapter 18. And I love this passage, and it's just a wonderful thing. Some things that he's shown me, and I pray that each one of you will be blessed as you also shall receive it. Amen. The word which came to Jeremiah from the Lord saying, arise and go down to the potter's house, and there I will cause you to hear my words. Then I went down to the potter's house, and there he was making something at the wheel. And the vessel that he made of clay was marred in the hand of the potter. So he made it again into another vessel, as it seemed good to the potter to make. Then the word of the Lord came to me, saying, O house of Israel, can I not do with you as this potter? Says the Lord, look, as the clay is in the potter's hand, so are you in my hand, O house of Israel. Give us strength, God. Wisdom and knowledge. Receive your word. You know, and one of the things that I look at, you know, we must come to a place that the Lord has said to come. In other words, we must, of our own free will, submit unto the hands of the potter that we receive that second chance. In other words, look, we have been beat up and tore up, and if you don't understand it, the word marred means disfigured, dismantled, incomplete. And in verse 4, it says, and the vessel that he made was marred, so he made it again into something that seemed good to the potter. Well, I want to talk about it, and that's mainly my main focus there, is that God wants to make something that's messed up into something that's good. God wants to take something that's so disfigured and so messed up that he wants to restore it. He wants to put it back together the way that it's supposed to be, to the vessel that it was from the very beginning. Now, you may feel that you as a person or as a man or a woman, that you are imperfect, that there's no way that you can go back. There's no way that you can be that young lady or that young man that was from the very beginning, when we were in our youth without sin, when we were in those times that we went out there fornicating and living those lifestyles in the world. I want to go back just to, all the way into the front of the Bible in Genesis 1:26. You don't have to go there. I'm going to read it out to you. It says, then God said, let us make man in our image according to our likeness. Now, from the very beginning, when God first created the earth and he created man and he created the sky and the stars and everything above and everything underneath, he said then that let us make man in our image according to our likeness. So in other words, when he made each one of us, when he made man, he made it to his likeness. It was perfect. It was exactly what he wanted. Each one of us was that perfect person when he created us. So we're going to fast forward back to Jeremiah 18, verse 4. It says, and the vessel that he made was marred. So he made it again into something that seemed good to the potter. So in other words, what's happening from the very beginning until when we fast forward to today, now we can understand that, look, that vessel that was made back then, that vessel that was made from the very beginning, it's been messed up. It's been disfigured. It's been dismantled. There's things that has happened in our lives that has caused us to backslide, caused us to become drug addicts and alcoholics, caused us to go out backwards instead of forward. But God says that today, today he has called us to the potter's house. He has called us to go forth into a place that he will let you know, as he told Jeremiah. He says, go, and there I will cause you to hear my voice. I don't know about you, but I was able to hear God's voice when he said, you need to get cleaned up. He said, you need to get away from those people. When he said, you need to stop doing what you're doing. When he said, I'm giving you something. Some of us has heard that voice today whenever he said, go unto the potter's house. Go to New Image Outreach. Call that number. Look, this is where I want you to go. There I'm going to cause you to hear my voice. I'm going to call you to hear my voice, that you shall be placed upon the potter's wheel, that you shall be disfigured, dismantled when you get there. But I want you to know that once you get there, I want to put you on the wheel, and I want to make you into something nice. I want to make you into something better than what you used to. I want to bring you back to the first love. I want to bring you back to the first place when you were first made. He wants to take all of that disfigurement. He wants to take the sin, the hatred, the anger, everything that has caused our lives to come to be unmanageable, that today he wants to make us something of his liking again. He said, and the vessel that he made was marred, so he made it again. He's saying that, look, the potter, well, it was messed up. When the potter first made us, we was perfect. We was without sin. Yes, we were born into sin, but I'm talking about that sin that we do willingly. That you're willing to go out there and get high. You're willing to put God on the back burner. This is the sin that we're talking about. That he wants to make you that new image again. He wants to make you in the image according to his likeness. Doesn't mean that he doesn't love us. He doesn't like us. The word says hate the sin, not the sinner. Amen. See, and I believe that God stands on his word whenever he says that. And if you look at it, he says in verse 6, he said, but now, O Lord, you are our Father. We are the clay, and you are the potter. Jeremiah finally heard the word of the Lord. He understood that, look, this is what I want you to do. This is what I want you to understand. He said, then the word of the Lord came to me, saying, this is when God came to you, huh? You're not here by your own free will. You're here because the Lord led you to.
Amen. Uh-huh. Yes, he did.
We're not being set free because you want to be set free. We're being set free because God has given you that desire.
Yeah, amen.
We no longer want to have the desire to serve the world. We no longer want to live according to the old man or the old woman. We want to get away from those things. We want to get away from the ways that we were living and get into something new and come into a resurrection, if you will, under the likeness of Christ. Isaiah 64:8 says, but now, O Lord, you are our Father, we are the clay, and you are the potter. Understand this. He says, O house of Israel, can I not do with you as this potter, says the Lord. Look, as the clay is in the potter's hand, so are you in my hand, O house of Israel. Understand that God wants you to be in his hand. He wants you to submit unto him and let him do with you the same thing that the potter did. That even though we're disfigured, even though we're messed up, we're tore up from the floor, tired of the lifestyle, you know the routine, even when you're out there getting high, you're tired of it, but you still smoke that joint. You're tired, but you still get into the scene because you don't know what, any other way. But you see, the potter wants to have you. He wants you to be shaped and molded into something new, into something of his liking. God doesn't get pleasure in us living a life of righteousness, a life of sin. That doesn't pleasure him. But what pleasures him is that we begin to live a life under the power and the anointing of the Holy Spirit, that we allow the potter, that we allow ourselves to be that clay, that we begin to be shaped and molded. Huh? Churches today are being those potters that they want to shape and mold. It's not that person that's doing it, but it's the spirit that once runs through. It's that spirit that runs through the anointing of the Lord that we shall be made new creations, that we shall grab a hold of something new. Many times we fail because we don't want to submit unto the Lord. We fail because we want to do our own thing. We fail because we want to follow our own doctrine. And the sad thing is a lot of times we're out there we're preaching false doctrine. Instead of leading people to Christ, you're getting them more confused. You're leading them backwards instead of forward. I'm glad that I'm not a man of education, because if I was, I would be up here. I would be preaching things to those that are uneducated into the word and we not understand. Mm-hmm. That we can come into the potter's house and understand that we want to submit not to man, but we submit unto God, and we allow God to begin to shape us and mold us and make us into that new creation, that no longer shall we walk according to the old, but according to the new. That we shall be lifted up and brought out of the pits of hell and put our feet on solid ground. That no longer shall we be made those that are stumbling, but that are walking hill high. That we shall become those men and women that are righteous in God's eyes, according to God's likeness, according to the likeness of the potter, that he shall shape us and mold us into the men and women that makes him happy, that satisfies the glory of God. Too many times we're running around doing things on our own accord, sadly disappointing our Lord. We take things and matters into our own hands and leading ourselves. I can do it by myself. I don't need nobody. As a pastor, I understand that I cannot do it without Christ. I cannot do it on my own. How do you know? Because I've tried. I tried for 35 years to lean on my own understanding and do things according to my own will. I put the job first. I put the money first. I put the woman first. I put my grandkids first. I put my children first. I put everything else first and failed. As a husband, as a father, as a grandfather, as a brother, as an uncle. Because I leaned on my own understanding. But today is a day that, look, I can be resurrected. Today is a day that when I stand before my Father, our Creator, before I go forth before Him, that I'm willingly submitting myself. If I was to go today, glory be to God, I will meet my Creator. Glory be to God that He shall be pleased. He shall come. I shall come before Him, and He shall announce, "Well done, my good and faithful servant. Enter into thy kingdom." He shall be pleased with what he has made of me.
Amen.
When we lean on our own understanding, church, he's not pleased. We have to understand that. He wants to make something new out of this. Huh? He doesn't want you to lean on that past anymore. It doesn't matter what you've done. It doesn't matter what you were doing yesterday. It doesn't matter what you did last week. It doesn't matter what you did 2 weeks ago. What matters is today. He says today is the acceptable year of the Lord. Today is the day of Jubilee. Today is the day that you shall be set free. Today is the day that he can make you into a new creation. He wants to shape you and mold you. All you got to do is submit yourself. All you got to do is come unto the Father's house and receive the glory that he's already has for you, and receive the gift of life and not death, that you shall be made whole again and not stumbling, but you shall be made to walk.
Amen.
Many times we fail to realize that we've been given a second chance. We fail to realize that he's been willing and wanting to give you a do-over. We've made things into our own hands to be so hard. We make things so hard that we can't grasp it anymore. We make things so hard because we done confused ourselves. We understand that one thing is that we have to be able to understand it and submit unto the Lord. Can you get that down, please? And us understand that it's through the glory of God that we shall receive the gift of the do-over. That he wants to make things new again. He wants to make you whole. He wants to that you no longer are living in the old ways. I've had people come and I want this. I want something different. I'm tired of the old ways. He wants that for you too. He wants that you shall be able to come and be on the potter's wheel, that he can shape you and mold you. He's not trying to hurt you. He's trying to take your hurt from you. He's not trying to make you stay the way you are. He's trying to fix your hurt. He's trying to fix your pains. He wants to soothe you. He wants to embrace you. He wants to comfort you. He wants to let you know that he is the head and not the tail. He wants to let you know that your past is gone forever. You no longer have to go backwards, but you can go forward. You can live for the glory. He wants to make you into that new creation. So many people that I see, that today's churches, that we come in and we're messed up. We come in and we're torn down. We come in and we're broken and we don't know which way to go. We don't know which way is going to help us. We don't know what to do. So we continue to walk on the path we were walking on. I want you to know something, that today is the day that he has called you to step up. He's called you to accept what it is that he's trying to give you. Jeremiah, when he said, go. Go into the potter's house. Arise and go to the potter's house, and there I will cause you to hear my word. You know that you're not here just by accident. You're here because he wants to give you a word. You're here because he wants you to hear his voice. You're here because he wants you. He wants to make something out of you. Some of you have been hurt. You've lived a life of sin, of things that you don't want to be. You begin to have feelings against yourself. Well, I can't be forgiven. I can't be blessed. Man, the sin that I've committed, oh, God's not going to forgive me. I'm here to let you know he has given you a redo. He's given you a makeup test. He's given you a situation that you can come and not be lost, but you will be found. He wants to raise you up and heal your broken heart, that no longer shall you walk being messed up and tore up, but he wants to make you whole. He wants to take your shame and turn it into joy. He wants to comfort you in the midst of your storm. He wants to turn that rainy day into a shiny day. He wants you to be lifted up and not torn down. Right now, you may be walking and you're disfigured. Well, ain't nothing wrong with me. I'm talking about that you got sin. Because if you're not doing the things that he called you to do from the very beginning, when he said, Then the God said, let us make man in our image, according to the likeness. God was perfect then, and he's perfect today. It didn't change. When he made us in his image back then, he made us a perfect creation. He made us a perfect man and a perfect woman. And if we are not perfect today, then you are marred. You are messed up. You're tore up. You're not the same that you were when he first made you. I think you have it made because you got a job, you got a car, you got a woman or a man. Matthew says, what good does it profit man to gain the whole world but lose his own soul? I say, what, that woman ain't gonna save me. My wife ain't gonna save me. My grandchildren, they ain't gonna save me. My children, they're not going to save me. But I can tell you who can.
Yes.
His name is Jesus. Mm-hmm. He's already paid the ultimate price. All he wants us to do is come to the potter's house. All he wants us to do is let him shape us and mold us. The problem with the church today, they don't want to submit.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not going to do what that man said. You got to do what I say. I told you, how are you going to say that you love the Lord, but you can't even submit unto your man if you see it? I don't say that, you know, I'm not nobody. I'm struggling to fight for my salvation. It takes me on a daily basis. I have the same problems. Don't nothing change because I have a title of a pastor. Don't nothing change because I have a title of a founder. Anything that makes it that much more. That much more that I should submit unto the Lord and say, good, I can't do it on my own. I can't do it leaning on my own understanding. I have to understand that he allows me to have another opportunity. Each one of us has that same opportunity today, that we shall seek the glory of God. Isaiah says that. But now, O Lord, you are our Father. We are the clay. See, he's given us an opportunity. Jeremiah, what he said, look, Lord, I know I was messed up. I did things that I didn't think were wrong. I lived my life out there under my own understanding. I did people dirty. I know there's nobody in this church. We're all saints here. Understand that. But you gotta stop and understand that there's churches out there that they're hurting. There's churches that leaning on their own understanding. There's churches out there that their members are lost and confused, believing in false doctrine and their own doctrine. They make their own things up. I'm glad we're not those churches. Glad it's not what we do. I'm glad each one of us has our lives in order that we don't have to take the opportunity to have a do-over. We don't have to sit on a pot of field because we're already perfect. Somebody hearing this? You think that we're better? You don't have to do that. I've got my life in order. You can't have your life in order if you... The Lord's come to me and said, hey, I want to instruct you. I want to make you a new creation. Malachi 3:7 says, yet from the days of your fathers, you have gone away from my ordinances and have not kept them. In other words, from the very beginning, if you go back again, back to Genesis 1:26, it tells you. Then God said, let us make man in our image, according to our likeness. We shall have dominion over the earth. There's too many of us that the earth has dominion over you. The world has dominion over you because you act like the world. You believe like the world believes. Well, it's okay for me to get high. It's okay for me to have two sugar mama. It's all right for me to talk to this guy and that guy. There's nothing wrong with that. But from the very beginning, he gave us the power and the authority. See, I give you the anointing, the authority, to trample upon serpents. I have dominion over the earth, above the earth, under the earth, and on the earth. Upon every creeping thing, every crawling thing, you know what? He has given us that authority. And if we're not taking that authority to fulfill what God is allowing us to fulfill in our life as men and women of God, to fulfill it and be placed on that promise word that he makes us into something that is good to him. We do things of the opposite. He says, from the days of your fathers, you have gone away from my ordinances and have not kept them. Return to me. How many of us have done things on our own accord? We're not living the life that he originally ordained for us to do. You can't tell me, I'm not doing what I used to do no more. Yeah, well, that's probably because you've been made to do it. Probably because you have to do it. You see, he don't want people that has to do it, that you're doing it because you're being made to do it. He told Jeremiah, look. He said, go to the potter's house, and there I will cause you to your ear to hear my voice. Come to church sometimes because we're made to come to church. I really wonder if you did not have to be here, how many people would actually come? He wants our greatness. That's what he says. From the days of your fathers, you have gone away from my ordinances and have not kept them. He says, return to me and I will return to you. This is the promise that he's given us. Well, how do I return to him? By submitting unto him. How do I return to him? By giving him what he wants. By allowing him to structure you, by allowing him to put his hands on you and make you into something that is pleasing to him. It says, to make you into something that's pleasing to you. Huh? Yeah, well, it's easy for you, Pastor, because there's times I want to go fishing. Huh? There's times I want to just lay in the bed and sleep all day. Huh? But that's not pleasing to him. Huh? We have a ministry to run. We have things we've got to do here. He's shaping me. Look, I'm not where I need to be. I'm not where I used to be, but look, I'm nowhere close to where I need. I need to continue to push forward. I need to continue to put myself on the potter's wheel so that he can shape me and mold me. And as I get up on a daily basis, okay, Lord, use me. Do whatever it is that you will with me, Lord. Show me. Well, you know what? You sit down, God. You ain't got to tell me nothing. I know what I'm supposed to do. I know what I'm going to do, and this is how I'm going to do it. We all have an opportunity that he gives us a do-over. He gives us an opportunity that we make a choice. Man, I want to serve you, Lord. Here I am, Lord. Do with me whatever it is that you want to do. Change me, mold me, shape me, Father God. And if it's something that I've messed up, then tear me down and bring me back up, Father God. Make me into your creation.
Amen.
That we could be whole again. That we could be made from the beginning new. That when he first made you. You see that little baby, a newborn. Oh, look, he's so cute. Oh, look at the little girl. Oh, man, she's so. Huh? Y'all remember? Some of y'all may not remember that. Huh? Remember, Mama tell me some stories. Oh, yeah, you're the cute baby. You're the bad baby. You had little chubby cheeks. Oh, you're handsome. Huh? What are people talking about you now? But it's just saying how good you are. What were they talking about when he was over there under the bridge? How were they talking about you when he was over there at the boathouse? How are they talking about you whenever you're walking down the street?
I said, why would they want you to go over there?
Oh, boy, come back over.
That's what they used to do to me, isn't
it? Here comes Chris. He's going to, don't say nothing. He's going to start something. He's going to start. He gets a bit.
Nobody running around. That's bad.
Nobody wants me around now, but because I'm a Bible thumper, huh?
Yeah. I love the Lord. You know what? Everything I do is about the Lord. My dad says, hey, let's pray. My brother says, well, hey, let's pray. No matter where I'm at, I don't care if I'm at your house. Or not. Well, I pray for my food.
Yeah.
Let God be pleased with you.
Let him, whatever he wants to do in your life, let him make you and mold you and shape you into what he wants you to be. Because guess what? When he's through with you and you're doing his will and you're accomplishing what he has for you to accomplish, I guarantee you that you will not last. The things that we talk about you, they're talking about your posture. I get accused of all kinds of stuff, man. So glory be to God. Glory be to God, because you know what? He's shaping me and molding me. I don't have to bow down to that woman. I'd jump on that fire if you were able to do it. Shape me and mold me, God. Get out of character sometimes. Hey, Lord, forgive me. I'm human. I don't stand to say that I'm perfect because I'm a pastor, because I founded this place. Hey, I got faults. I understand if you want to leave and you want to go find that perfect pastor, you go right ahead. It'll be a perfect pastor until you show up there. You understand what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
If you don't understand, I'm going to break it down for you. He's a perfect pastor until you get there and you don't like the way he's running things, then he ain't the perfect pastor anymore.
Mm-hmm.
This is the perfect place while you're here. As soon as you don't get it your way, guess what? Now, I don't like that place. You ain't coming on the parish with it. You ain't letting God deal with you. You're trying to please man. And what I say is you're trying to please yourself. But when you submit unto God and you let God deal with you and God lead you and God shape you and mold you and make you into that man or woman that he desires for you to be, guess what? You humble yourself. Not for Pastor Chris, not for Pastor White. You open yourself for the glory of God.
Mm-hmm.
Because he sustains you. He's the party. He's the one that wants to show you and mold you. Each one of us has that opportunity to do the deal. From the very beginning, you were created in his image. Somewhere down the line, we messed up. Somewhere down the line, we went through it. Went through the car wash and the brushes weren't working. Went through the car wash and he still came out dirty. See what I'm saying? Simply, man, I love the Lord and the Vic was still hanging on to the bed. Man, I'm a Christian, man. God can't restore you unless you allow him to restore you. He wants to take you and mold you and shape you and to make you that woman, man, that you know what, that he originally wanted you. A woman of integrity, a woman of valor, man of valor. And when you walk around, man, you know what, you don't have to be defeated. I don't know. I'm happy. Some days I have money to give me ice cream, some days I don't. Praise the Lord. Every opportunity I have, I try to bless somebody. Because that's what he does to me. He gives gives him the opportunity to be able to do that. He says together, he says, return to me and I will return to you. Says the Lord of hosts. But you said, in what way shall we return? Return to your first love. You remember when some of you are Christians, huh? When you first became a Christian, all you wanted to do was talk about the Bible and talk about the Word. You want to lay your hands on it, but hey, bro, let me pray for you. Huh? Seeking every opportunity to give God the glory. Now you can't even get you to open up the Bible. Huh? It's sad because you have to dust it off whenever you open it. Should be that way. The way for us to return to him is to submit unto him. He says, cling to me and I will cling to you. He also said, if you deny me, I'm going to deny you. He said to do what he loves us. He loves us enough that he reminds us. Oh, the same thing that he did with Jeremiah. Oh, he's telling us, Lord, go to the Potter's Field. Go to the Women's Outreach. Go and wait there. I'm going to send you a word. Some of us, because we're doing it on our own understanding, the word that you give, you don't like. I don't like that word. I don't like that review. The devil is a lie. The devil is a lie. That's why you're not submitting yourself. When you say that you love the Lord and you're going to submit, and you're a man of God and a woman of God, but you can't submit yourself unto the authority. I'm not talking about my authority. I'm talking about the Lord's authority. You're still out there holding on to your sin. You're still out there doing things that, it's not about me. You know what? I'm just here to do what I'm supposed to do. Because I can honestly say, when I stand before my Creator, I've done everything in my power to do the best that I could possibly do for each one of you guys.
Amen.
Each one of you women. And that's what I'm saying to my God. You know what? I do what I have to do. From the least to the greatest. You know what? Hey, it's not about me. Even when I'm tired. Earlier this morning, I came over here, took care of business here, went over here, got the next day, dropped some stuff off at my father-in-law, he gave me some paperwork, went home, made the paperwork, got ready for things, and came over here. Still, an hour and 15 minutes early, I believe it is. Because I want to submit, you know what, I want God to use me in any way possible. And I cannot be used unless we are purified, unless he's molding us and shaping us. I don't know about you, but I want to jump on that potter's wheel right now.
Amen.
He says today is the acceptable year of the Lord. This is in Luke 4:19. He says today is the acceptable year of the Lord. And if you backtrack that into, I believe it's Isaiah, talks about the day of Jubilee. That's the day that all sins and all debt has been forgiven. Church, I don't know. You got debts to it. You got sin. But he said that today is the day that they will be forgiven. All you have to do is come to him. All you have to do is submit to him. If you got hurts and pains and sorrows and you know what, man, you got things that you know, that regrets. Today's the day that you can give it all up. You don't have to worry about it. Your past will be gone forever. But you can walk and be set free. You don't have to have that weight on your back anymore. You don't have to have that pain in your heart. You don't have to do the things that you've been doing to supplement because you're hurting. to suffer me because that man that left or that woman that left. You know what? I just got left.
You know what to get you, man?
I'll make it on my own. I don't need you. All I need is my Budweiser. All I need is my pipe. All I need is my pills. But I do it alone. I don't need my man. I don't need a woman. Those of you that do have women, you want to sit there and you treat them wrong. That's God's plan. This is God's sin. You want to sit there and cuss them out. You want to sit there and belittle them. That's not what God created it for. He created it so that we could be those men and women. He wants to mold us and shape us. He wants us to submit unto Him, to get under His hands. Let Him do what He's got to do with you. It's going to hurt a little bit. It may not be to your liking. But guess what? I guarantee you that at the end, the results that you will receive are so great. The pain will be gone. The situation's not holding you down anymore.
Somebody hear this? You don't have to go through it. He said, today is the acceptable year of the Lord.
Today is the day of liberty. Statue of Liberty represents Statue of Freedom. Let today represent the day that you are being set free. The day that the bondage that has been holding you down shall release you.
Let's go ahead and stand.
No, he didn't ever intend for us to be like this. He didn't intend for us to be broken, tore from the floor, addicts, men and women that are filled with hatred and anger and unforgiveness. It's not what he wanted. Sit there and I'll be mistreated in it. You know what? Let him call me to God. Get in my prayer closet and I pray. Man, God, you know what? Just continue to move in my life, Father God. Continue to allow me to be the man that I need to be. Even when they disrespect me. It reminds me, he said, before they hated you, they hated me. Don't look at it as odd. Don't look at it as messed up that they're doing you like that. They did it to me. And they're still doing it to me. That you can be released from the pains. You can be released from the sin, from the sorrow. That you can be made into a new creation. That no longer shall you be held captive. No longer shall you be blind. No longer shall you be brokenhearted. No longer shall you be bound, shackled, and chained to the ways of the world. But you shall be released. You shall have freedom. You shall be set free. You have another opportunity. Another chance to do it over. Another chance to start anew. Another chance to be the father that you weren't before. Another chance to be a good husband. Another chance to be a good wife. Another chance to be a good daughter. Another chance to be a good father. Another chance. Stop holding on to the old way.
Yeah.
He said, today is the acceptable year of the Lord. What about a something for him? Oh, Father God, I thank you, Lord. I thank you, Lord. I thank you, Father God, Jesus. Every eye closed, just right there where you're at.
simple. If there's anything that's holding you back, if you want to be set free, accept that today is the acceptable year of the Lord, the day of liberty, the day of your freedom. Just right there where you're at, just raise your hand and get it back down. Don't be ashamed. Don't worry about who's next to you. Don't worry about who's watching. The one we need to be worrying about watching, that's God. Whatever it is that you're struggling with, you may feel like you can't be forgiven. You may feel that your sin is so great that there's no way that he would forgive you. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. He said that sexual immorality is forgiven. He said, give it to me. He said, give it to me. He said, that addiction, give it to me. The fornication, the lustfulness, let it be not amongst you any longer, but you shall be set free. Say, let go of that unforgiveness. Let go of that unforgiveness. He said, I created you to love, not to hate. He said, I came that the captives shall be set free. Unless you give it unto him today, you'll walk away still in captivity. Whatever you're holding on to, he said, he has the power and the pleasure of releasing. He said he wants to make your path a straight path. He wants you to walk in green pastures, in peace, in comfort. But if you hold on to that anger, he said, you're holding yourself in bondage. Spirit of anger, you have no place in this house. Father God, we come before you, Father God. I come before you, Father God, Jesus, that the anointing of the Holy Spirit, Father God, shall fall, Father God, upon you. Father God, right now, Father God, begin to release them. Begin to release them. Take it. Take it, Father. It's right there where you are. Give it to me. Say, I give it to you, Lord. I give you my anger. I give you my lustfulness. I give you my addiction. I give you my affliction. I give it to you, Father God. Father God, you are the creator, Father God. Father God, you made us in your precious image, Father God, that from the very beginning, Father God, we shall be made, Father God, perfect in your eyes. Father God, we ask you right now, Father God, that you remove those shackles, Father God, of addiction. Remove the shackles, Father God, of anger and hatred, spirits of captivity, Father God. Release it. Release it. Holy Spirit, we invite you right now that you come and just touch. Soften the hearts. Soften the Lord. Oh, Father God, Jesus, pour your anointing. Begin to break the barriers, Father God. The barriers, Father God, of the unforgiveness. The barriers, Father God, of holding on to the past. The barriers, Father God, Jesus, of not accepting you for who you are. We continue to want to follow false doctrine. Father God, release us, Father. Lead our path, lead our direction, Father God. Make us whole, Father God. Renew us, Father God. Renew our spirits, Father God. Oh, Father God, as we come, Father God, unto the potter's house, Father God, Lord, you shape us and mold us, Father God. Father God, that you take things out, Father God, and put good things in, Father God. Father God, that you take something old, Father God, and replace it with something new, Father God. Father God, pour your spirit of anointing, Father God. Pour your healing, Father God. Pour your forgiveness, Father God. Pour your love, Father God. Father God, remind us, Father God, that you are the head and not the tail. Father God, remind us, Father God, that no longer shall we be brokenhearted, Father God, but that, Father God, we shall be healed. We shall be made alive, Father God, and not dead, Father God. We shall call upon your name, Father God, and be set free. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah,
hallelujah.
Oh, we give it all to you, Father God. Oh, Father God, shape us and mold us, Father God, into those that you want us to be. Cleanse us, Father God, from all unrighteousness. Cleanse us, Father God, Jesus. Oh, Father God, that we no longer lean on our own understanding, Father God. Shape us, mold us, Father God. Make us into those new creations, Father God. Oh, Father God, that you are so happy and proud of, Father God, that you shall say, well done, my good and faithful servant. It is good, and it is done. In Jesus' precious name, we give you the glory. Everyone say,
amen. Amen.